Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment.
Today's episode of The Mike O'Mara Show is brought to you by our bonus packages. Please go to MikeO'MaraShow.com and click on the bonus banner. You'll get access to all of our bonus content, and even better, you'll be helping out TMOS. So please, quit sucking, and we thank you.
Available on demand every day in iTunes and the Google Play Store, and around the world on MikeO'MaraShow.com. What more can we do for you? It's The Mike O'Mara Show.
Welcome to the Mike O'Mara Show. Tis the season. We are a little over a week away from the big holiday, the big eating holiday, Thanksgiving, where we all gather around the table and enjoy each other's company. And as we come into the show today, I'm reminded of the story of the soldier that was sitting in the trench in World War One, and a German soldier was standing at him with his gun pointed right at him, and he froze.
Oh.
That's the story that I have today. So
perhaps he meant like he stood still, but he literally froze.
He froze. He didn't do anything.
I didn't realize that.
We have that. Anyway,
that's the show before the show.
That's the show before the show. I won't go into detail about it, but it's just frustrating. It gets me crazy. Kooky, kookula, crazy. And Maddie, send me a bill because I ranted and raved again, but I didn't do it on the air.
Today's a pass.
Today's a pass.
Just to get a little wound up when I'm ready to do it.
Yeah, today's a full pass.
Without further ado, we've been talking a lot about Dick Oliver for the purposes of discussion.
Ollie,
do you happen to have any, either the Dick Oliver or the Saturday Night Live tape of Dick Oliver?
I think
Which is Herb Welch.
Yes, hold on.
So we can give a little example, because I think we're going to have either Dick Oliver or Herb Welch call. Well, they're one and the same.
Are they? They're
Butterball
very similar, right?
Today, just to, just to give it a little go there. And if you don't have it handy, I think people have listened to enough of the show to know what's going on. A guy that doesn't know how to cook.
I don't see that as being
it.
A typical process, nor do I.
All right, here we go.
Process.
It's the one I want.
I've
got
to go now. Thank you, brother. Thank you. All right, it's back to you, Jim.
Don't let her go away. Does she have a response to that? Is she still there?
What's that?
Did the lady just leave?
Yeah.
Oh, that's too bad. You should have kept that discussion.
She's back if you want her.
Yes.
She heard you.
Yes.
What would you like to know?
I'd like to know a response to what the gentleman said. The gentleman's a very effective spokesperson for the company, but obviously the people who live there are not satisfied with his explanation.
Right. So what do you want now?
Well, if I have to teach you how to be a reporter, Ollie, I'll do that later.
Why don't you do that later, Jim? I think the lady expressed herself, and you're not here, you're there. Is there any question you'd like me to ask her?
And no, I'll give you lessons on how to become a reporter later.
I'll give you some lessons on how to be an editor, because I was your boss once.
Yeah, you were, and are no longer. How did that happen?
Here's
Aaron Abildemillo.
Sick bird.
Good morning, Jim.
Mike, you always call attention to the fact that he says, and are no longer.
And I no longer. All right, let's call the Butterball Turkey Hotline, shall we? Let's see if we get lucky, and let me make sure I've got all my volumes turned up here like this.
Welcome to Butterball. To be connected to our Butterball Turkey Talk Line, for information on turkey preparation and cooking assistance, press or say 3. If you have, your call may be monitored or recorded
to ensure quality
customer service. Thank you for calling the Butterball Turkey Talk Line. All turkey experts are assisting other callers.
Mm. Your estimated wait time is about 2 minutes.
For self-service options to frequently asked questions,
no problem.
Press 1. Or visit Butterball.com.
A lot of people aren't cooking their dinner yet.
For information on turkey preparation, recipes, and more.
I have to do it the week before.
If you would like to leave a callback number and keep your place in line, press 2.
It'd be great to leave a message.
For the next available expert.
Hello?
No messages, no.
Hello?
Do we have music?
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Line? Is that the line?
That's the line. Mine was the prayer of Thanksgiving.
Isn't that peaceful, though, that you have that? And now, usually, it's my experience, if it's less than 5 minutes, you usually you get through pretty quickly.
You know,
and
they've
also been trained to be savvier in the last couple of years. So I have to be delicate about this. I can't really get into mine.
Oh, wait.
Here we go.
Good morning. This is Butterball Turkey Talk Line. How could I help you?
Hi, I want to know about I'm cooking a turkey.
Okay, a whole bird, I take it.
For the first time, and
They told me to call the number just to find, well, how do I do it?
Okay, very good. I need to know the size bird, approximate, you know, do you have?
What do you want to know?
Bird. How big is that turkey? A 15 pound, 10, roughly?
I haven't bought it yet. I don't, are they spicy? I don't want spicy.
No, the whole birds just have a little saltwater solution within. They salt don't water, have.
What do you mean a salt? What's a saltwater solution?
It's just to help keep it moist while you're cooking. Most you know, chickens, poultry,
they're not spicy.
Other products.
They're not spicy.
No. It's just a little bit of, you know, added moisture to keep it, you know, nice and
added what?
Tender and moist while you cook it.
Added what? What? Added moisture?
It adds some more moisture, so it doesn't get real dry. A larger bird has to be in the oven, you know, a longer time to get all of it cooked, and you don't want it to get dried out. So that's why.
What's a larger bird? What size is a large bird?
12 pounds or more. You're probably going to get something of that size, or are you going to get something smaller? We do have small ones too. We have they call them little butterballs.
Just for me.
So maybe then you would want to select our little butterball.
I got a neighbor down the hall that might be coming over, so I need to know. I need to know if the bird is I can either eat it or the neighbor and I can eat it. So what size do I need for that?
Right. Yes. Huh? So what I think. You selecting a little butterball, which is less than 9 pounds, would be the perfect product for you.
Less than 9 pounds? That's like a
chicken,
isn't it?
Well, some of them come 7, 8, or 9. Yeah, that's like a chicken, exactly, which would be a perfect size for both of you.
Yeah. Can I, is it frozen?
Oh. It is frozen.
Oh.
So you'll have to thaw it in the refrigerator for a couple of days.
I wanted to look, I saw a picture in Life magazine, or it might have been Look magazine, that had one of the birds. I wanted to look good, even though it's a small bird. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Can I get it small with the legs and all that? The bows, that paper? Huh?
Yes, you can.
All right.
So you want to purchase.
Yeah. Can I thaw it in my bread box?
It would fit in there. It's about that size, you know, but like I said, it's called a little butterball, like L-I-L, then they put an abbreviation, butterball. It's in the frozen section. You can ask the grocer. They keep these little butterballs all the time in the stores.
Yeah. When do they give them out?
Size, like a little football, you know, it's about
when,
the size.
When do they give them out?
They're in the stores right now.
What do you mean?
You can go to the store right now and purchase this little butterball.
Well, they're not giving them out?
Oh, they're not giving them for free. No, you have to purchase them.
Huh. All right. So you got a baby buddy, what do you call it? Baby bird?
We call it little butterball turkey.
Can I get it with war? Can I use my war bonds to get it?
I don't know what your grocer does. We're just here to help you to cook the bird. We're not selling them. The grocer has his own, protocol that he has to follow. I don't know.
My neighbor said that I could leave it out because I don't have heat. I don't have heat in my apartment.
We do not suggest, that's an unsafe thing to do with poultry.
Well, it's cold in my apartment, though. It's cold. So I put it in the ice box?
Yes, put it in the refrigerator. And it'll keep there for about 4 or 5 days, and then you need to cook it.
All right. Do I use, a pan?
So we suggest you put it in a shallow pan, you know, not a real high side pan. You want it shallow.
Yeah.
And then you want to put it up on a rack or something to lift it up so it doesn't sit in all of its juices. But if you don't have a rack, you know, you can just put it in your pan.
Yeah.
Brush it with some vegetable oil, or you can rub it down with butter, If you want to put salt and pepper on it or a little paprika, anything of your flavorings, do that.
Paprika.
And it's probably, it should take about, you know,
I like,
two hours at 325.
I got taco seasoning. Can I put that on there?
I like taco flavor. If you like the taco flavor, then
like
you can
that.
Put it on there.
If I have leftovers, can I take them to the workhouse?
Can you take them where?
If I have leftovers, if there's more, can I take them down to an orphanage or the workhouse?
I'm sure they'd appreciate that.
Hmm. When do we say grace?
Usually right before you eat.
All right. So what about the influenza? I don't want to have my neighbor over. There's a lot of the vaccine. I thought they already...
You know what?
I thought they already cured polio.
Yeah, we have no issues with any type of troubles with our birds or with our workers.
Yeah.
So everything, I mean, Butterball is considered
When do you take my order? When do you take my order?
I don't do the order. I'm just here to help you cook it. You have to go to the store.
I'll cook it. I just want to know, but I order it from you, right?
No, you don't. You don't order from us.
Why not?
Because what service is the 800 number is a cooking line. It helps people how to cook their turkey, not to purchase it, not to buy it, not to, you know, come and pick it up or deliver it. It's once you have your turkey, you want to know how to cook it. Like you said, you have a small area. You know,
you work for Butterball?
Yes.
Yeah. But I don't order it from you. I buy it at a store.
That is correct.
All right. What do I use to cook it with? As far as what do I put on it? I know you said the taco seasoning's okay, but do I put, what can I put on it? Can I use Brill Cream?
You can use some butter on it, or you can use some vegetable oil.
I got that. I got vegetable oil. I got, I got Crisco.
That's great. You can put that over it. Some people use mayonnaise. That's, again, these are personal preferences. But really just a little bit of something to kind of seal that skin so the skin doesn't just crisp up and fall off.
Should I get my priest to bless it?
You don't have to do that. Sir, is there anything else that I can help you with?
What temperature?
We've got
what temperature?
325 degrees is the oven.
Where's the gravy come from?
From the drippings of your turkey.
I don't want to make a mess. I don't like spills.
Yeah, so you can purchase gravy packets. You can purchase gravy in a can. I think even this little Butterball comes with a little packet in there. I don't do as many selling. Let me look up.
And we got to stuff it? Also, you got to stuff it, right? Stuff it.
You don't have to stuff it. You can stuff it, but you don't have to. If you're stuffing it, it takes a little bit longer.
Can I use
to cook?
Can I use sauerkraut?
That's a personal choice. We don't sell that.
You don't sell it.
We don't sell sauerkraut. We're
all right. I wrote it down 325 for 6 hours for the baby bird.
No. Huh? 325 for about 2.5 hours.
That's not enough.
Well. You have a meat thermometer. You can test it with the meat thermometer.
I got a thermometer.
Yeah, 170 degrees.
I wouldn't put that in anything I'm going to eat.
Yeah, so it goes in the breast, and it would read 170.
I wouldn't put the thermometer in anything I'd eat.
Well, then you can also just, you know, pierce the leg and look for clear running juices. You don't want any tinge of red or.
I got an outdoor thermometer too, but
You need a meat thermometer.
I can't put a magnet on. No, that's not going to work. 325 for 2 hours.
About 2 hours.
With oil on the outside of the bird, no stuffing, and no sauerkraut. Loose lips sink ships.
Yeah.
How do I get my priest to bless it?
That's something you'll have to handle.
All right. I don't know if I got any more questions for you. You've been very. What's your name?
Marcy.
Marcy, sad about that Lindbergh kid, huh?
I guess so.
What about peanut butter? Can I use? I love peanut butter. Can I? That's a side dish, right?
Right. I have heard people who put that on top of their bird because, you know, peanut butter has the oil in it. Then you're going to get kind of that peanut flavoring.
I got it.
Like you
hot
said,
candy.
You like tacos.
Hot candy for dessert. Okay. Get some lemon drops.
Yeah.
Just going to be me.
Thing. Yeah.
Do I need to send out a formal, my neighbor down the street, I'm thinking about sending him a card. Hey, come on over for
a nice touch. I think a personal note is always a nice touch.
Do I need flowers?
Again, nice personal touch,
table?
But not required.
I've only got one set of utensils. I get a fork, a knife, and a spoon.
Well, then you'll have to go and do some sharing.
No heat.
Or maybe he has some.
Just don't understand that. Can I use leftovers afterwards? Make a sandwich?
Absolutely. I would.
What kind of bread for the sandwich?
Again, personal choice. Personal choice. Nice, soft, fluffy white bread is what I'd go with, but whatever, you know, it's a personal choice.
Can I go over my notes? I was writing down, and you've been very good at what you've been saying. You're a nice lady.
Thank you.
I wrote down what you said. Cooking oil, check. 325 temperature.
Yes.
I'm not sure my oven's going to go that high. I don't know if it's going to go that high. And
it might take a little longer, but yeah, I think it'll be all right.
5 to 6 hours at 325. And
well, not 5 to 6 hours. We said about 2 to 3 hours. 2.5 hours.
How's it going to cook?
2.5 hours.
How the hell is it going to cook then if it's going only for 2 hours?
Leave it in there for 2.5 hours alone. Don't open it. Don't open the oven. Just put it in at 325 and leave it alone. After 2.5 hours.
My oven only gets up to about $1.75. I cooked one of them frozen pizzas in it, and it came out hard.
Well, with turkey, you've got a lot more issues with bacteria, so you don't want it to be in kind of a raw state for very long. You need to get it cooked, and we don't like anything less than about 300 degrees. So if you don't have that, perhaps the better thing to do is right even at your deli counters. They sell the actual turkey that they've cooked it, and they slice your slices for you.
I want to cook it. It's the tradition. I want to cook the bird, but the oven, I have an International Harvester oven.
Okay.
And it doesn't heat as much. I'll warm a biscuit in it or a McMuffin. I like McMuffins.
But right. Do you have a microwave?
What sort of thing is that?
That's something that cooks by waves through your food to get
it's
it cooked.
Like the ocean?
No, it's similar like what they use. Somewhat like that in space, but you don't probably, then you don't, if you don't know it, then you don't have a microwave. I think I'd be concerned for you if you don't have an oven that gets beyond 300 degrees.
I'm concerned for me. I got something in my armpit. I got something. It was a mole. Now it looks like something that something they found on Normandy. Loose lips sink ships. That's what they used to. That's right. My dad used to tell me all the time there. But
I was gonna say my dad too. I've heard that before.
Oh boy, that was a good one. We got them though. We got those Nazi bastards. Oh boy, I want to have my neighbor over and cook the real small bird. And I think that I've got if I can get that oven to work, can I put Can I put some coals in the oven and maybe have it heat faster?
Yeah. Huh? I don't think so. I think it's an electric oven or a gas oven, so that won't work.
Yeah. You're a very nice lady. I don't talk to people very often anymore. Okay. You're very, very... Do you sell Jell-O on your website?
No, we just like I said, we're just here with Butterball. So
Jell-O salad. That's my mother made that. That's crap. I don't believe in that. I don't understand that she put little pieces of melon in it. I didn't like melon anyway. Right. So if you're going to put it in lime Jell-O, that's not going to make it much better, as far as I'm concerned. I don't understand why they're doing that.
So, you know, it's your dinner. If that's not quite your thing, then I wouldn't.
Damn right it is. It's my dinner. That's what I told the. That's what I told my wife a few. Hello?
Yes, I'm here.
Yeah, I told my wife before she left me. She left me 1948. No, I'm sorry, 58. 58, I'm sorry. 58, right before I went to Korea. She was a good lady. She, she was a. If she was here, I wouldn't. If she was here, I wouldn't have to worry about doing the bird myself.
Right. Yes, it's hard. I understand. Sir.
It's hard time of year.
Yep.
Want to have my neighbor over?
Yep.
Yeah, if he's alive, I haven't knocked on his door since the Carter administration.
Yep. You be thankful for the things that we do have. And be thankful that you have somebody so much that you
listen. Loaf of bread, huh?
That's the greatest.
Loaf of bread's a good thing, isn't it?
If you, yes, it is.
I went down to my local bakery and not my bakery, my local grocery store. It's hard to buy even a loaf of bread down there. I don't want to do it. He's from that country we fought, you know, when we went over the parallel line, you know.
Right.
Scares me.
Well, I know it's very difficult for you, sir, and I appreciate you calling. I feel I've helped you, but, you know, there's like 50 other people waiting in line. We've got 10 of us answering these calls here today. It's a very busy time.
I know.
So
I'm thinking
I wish you best of luck. And I
hold
want
on
you
a
to
sec.
Remember.
One last thing. Can I just tell you one last thing? I'm going to get a damn bucket of chicken. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to get a bucket of chicken and just put a bow on it. That's what I'm going
to
do.
There you
Screw
go.
The bird.
We just need to be grateful. For the things we do have. So
you like the Andrews sisters?
My dad was a big fan.
Yeah. Don't sit under the apple tree.
That was my favorite
with
one.
With anyone else
My dad used
me.
To sing it, right? With anyone else with me.
Yeah.
Until I come marching home. I know. I know the song. My dad used to sing it. So did my mom. So, well, God bless you, sir. And thank you
can
for
I just tell you one last?
Country.
Can I just tell you one last story?
All right.
I was a little boy. And we had a neighbor. We had a neighbor, Timmy O'Brien, and he threw a rock at me. And the rock hit me on my right eye and almost took the eyebrow clean off. That was a drag. That hurt like hell. That hurt like hell. Never looked the same after that. Didn't affect my vision, though. But I did okay with it.
Yeah,
he had a big family. They had the dinner. I went to the Thanksgiving at their house one time. They had a big, big bird. But then the father drank, and they had a hell of a fight afterwards. It's not fun. I never went back. I told I told my mother. I said, I'm not going over there because they fight. Why didn't you have Thanksgiving? But we didn't have a lot. But we had a bird. But I'm gonna get a bucket of chicken.
Okay.
Well, I'm going to get a bucket of chicken and have a peanut butter sandwich or two and a glass of early times whiskey.
Or six.
You've been really nice. I hope you have a great
thank you. You too,
holiday.
Sir. Be thankful for what you have, and God bless you.
Are you leaving?
Take care. I have to leave.
Can I tell you one more quick story?
Oh, this is going to be the last one, sir, because I do have to hang up. They're buzzing at me in the ear that I need to get on. Thank you.
I used to go fishing down by the pond next door to the river, and I caught a catfish. Big one, too. Big one, like 2 pounds, 2.5 pounds. And we cut it up, and we ate it. We put it in a fry pan, and it tasted like manure. It was horrible. I don't know what it ate, but it was horrible. That's the same kid, Timmy O'Brien, that threw the rock.
Oh, dear.
Dear.
Well.
325, but I'm going to get a bucket of chicken.
Yeah. That'll be your Safeway, sir. That way you'll be
I don't do Safeway. I go to Piggly Wiggly.
Oh, that's a good one.
Yeah, that's
Very
a good one.
Good.
Yeah.
All right, sir. You enjoy, and thank you for calling.
You're there, and I'm here.
Happy Yep. Happy Thanksgiving to you. I must let you go now.
What time is it there?
Oh, it's about quarter to nine. Yeah, I don't know where you are, but
I got an old watch.
Thank you, sir.
I got an old Hamilton. It's a pocket
watch. All right,
sir.
I have to let you go. I'm sorry.
I don't know what's going on with it. I'm trying to get the watch fixed. Do you know where I can get a watch serviced? A good one?
I don't really know, sir. So I'm going to send you farewell and happy Thanksgiving from Butterball. Take care. Bye-bye.
This watch is a Hamilton. She gone?
Gone.
Rob, I got a kicker line that we have.
Oh.
Turn that off, please. Thank you. Are you ready to take it?
Yes.
I guess she hung up on me.
Gone.
Oh, man. What a bitch.
It's the Mike O'Mara Show. You can listen to the Mike O'Mara Show at www.mikeomarashow.com.
Stay tuned for an outstanding entertainment program.
It's the Mike O'Mara Show.
Let's get down to business.
From the entertainment capital of the world.
It's the Mike O'Mara Show. Mike O'Mara, Rob Spiewak, Oscar Santana.
And now, from his easy chair, here's Mike.
Who knew that Dick Oliver would have the magic to keep the lady on the line for a record amount of time?
Excellent job. And also, our statisticians just handed me this, Mike. Apparently, Dick's wife left him 62 years ago.
We are live from the Podcast Village Studios in our nation's capital, Washington, D.C. This is the Mike O'Mara Show. The Mike O'Mara Show, or TMOS to our friends, is a worldwide podcast and radio show with a family of listeners who are unrivaled in their love and support of the program. Let me get this right. There we are. Thank you very much. Sit back, relax, and prepare to be entertained from Columbia Falls, Montana, Cambridge, Maryland, Leukenbach, Texas, Port Harbor, North Carolina, and it's Leukenbach. Not Leukenbach. Port Harbor.
Leukenbach.
Point Harbor, North Carolina. Hollywood, Florida. And Deborah Buran, Ethiopia. The Mike O'Mara Show is on now, brought to you by Public Rec. I'll be honest, ever since we've been dealing with the COVID, fashion hasn't exactly been a top priority. Come on now. But feeling sloppy eventually gets old, and no one wants to see you running around your neighborhood in your old sweats. It's a pants-demic, and the only cure is Public Rec. They make leisure wear in waist and inseam sizes because comfort starts with a better fit. My favorite pants are their best-selling all-day, everyday pants. They're more stylish than sweatpants and a great alternative to jeans. Great for lounging at home, looking sharp for work, heading to the bar, and everywhere in between. And Public Rec has incredibly comfortable shorts, t-shirts, Henleys, polos, hoodies, jackets, even golf gear.
Yep.
Public Rec rarely offers discounts, but right now they have an exclusive offer just for our listeners. Go to publicrec.com/TMOS and use promo code TMOS to receive 10% off. That's publicrec, spelled REC.com/TMOS, and use our promo code TMOS for 10% off. Yes, there it is. Woo! The traditional call to the Butterball turkey. Thank you for not giggling in the background. That gave us away 1 year.
Wasn't easy. Wasn't very easy. I'm sorry to hear about his watch.
His Hamilton.
His Hamilton watch.
His Hamilton watch that he had. So welcome to the show. How's everybody doing? How's your COVID? How's your life? How's your world? I am exhausted after that Dick Oliver bit. No, I'm not. I'm very, very happy. Great to be with everybody. Lots to cover on the show today.
Yes.
As far as to get the fruitcake update, to get Oscar going down to the MAGA rally and the NFC East. And a Florida wildlife update, but we got the Butterball turkey hotline out of the way. Those ladies are doing the Lord's work.
Mercy.
God bless
so
her.
Patient.
Yes,
so
yes.
Absolutely patient.
I think they may have a rule that they try not to hang up on.
And
people,
I applaud you, Mike, because you were able to get her off script, which is not easy with something like that. Because
yes,
you kept throwing her the curveballs. I didn't even know International Harvester made cookware.
Do you know why I said that? Seriously?
Why?
We had in my basement, I'm old enough to tell you, for years, for my entire childhood into my college years, and probably after that, in my basement, we had a second refrigerator all the way down in the basement.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't have a big house, so it was a big deal to have a second refrigerator.
Yeah.
It was so old that at one point, I think my dad did this, or maybe my sister did this, they spray painted it metallic copper. So it was kind of a different color.
Right.
It was an International Harvester refrigerator.
You got to describe it to me. Did it have the
curved
edges?
You know what? I might
be
able to. Let me look while we're talking here, and I will try to find a picture of an International Harvester refrigerator, because I know it's a thing. I'm almost certain that it's a thing.
Growing up, this is double dynamite in our house, because our old refrigerator was a GE, but it looked like a honeymooner's refrigerator, not a corner on it. It was all curved, because when they bought it in the 50s, it was supposed to be like space-aged. And by the time I was around, it only got down to about 55 degrees. So you wouldn't want to put like dairy in it, but you could cool things in it. But International Harvester built Big Daddy's tractor that he drove for so many years. So I actually learned to drive a stick shift on an International Harvester tractor, a Farmall 140.
I got it.
You got it?
I found it. I will show you the picture of it. This is a fancy one that's been modified to have a beer tap on it. I don't want to show you that one. That's not the one I want
bet,
to
you know
show
you. What, Mike? I bet it is collectible now. I bet they're collectible
well, it's
now.
It's gone. It's with my mom now.
So it didn't convey when you sold the house?
They didn't keep it.
No.
There we go.
No.
I'll show it to you right there. There it is. There it is.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. That's very nice.
That is a hefty handle.
Yeah.
Yeah. Jeez. That's what I remember about it. It had the big hefty handle. Had a big giant handle on it, and it was a tank.
And it had a better ice maker than your current refrigerator.
Although, I will tell you this, that last night I decided enough is enough. Mrs. O'Mara, who has been very busy lately, by the way, I will mention her website maybe later this week if we could do that.
Good.
I told her, you know, I said, if we've got a spot available, I'd like to let you know. That's a little nepotism. That's my version of nepotism.
She's got a button on the website, Mike O'Mara.
Yeah, yeah, or as the kids say, the, button.
A button. And what it was she goes to bed early, and I realized that I had just done a deep thaw on my Samsung refrigerator ice maker the other day again. It lasts about 2.5 weeks, and then I got to thaw it again.
Do you pour water through it, or do you actually disconnect it, or how do you do it?
There is a button.
On the
refrigerator that gives you a forced defrost.
Nice.
I know everything. I could repair these right now with all the YouTube videos that I've watched. So it's a forced defrost, and then you go, and where the water has caked underneath the ice maker, you kind of chip it off, and it falls down because it's been on defrost. And I chip all the ice out, then I wipe it down, I towel it off, get it all dry on the inside, and then
labor-intensive.
I put the ice thing back in, and I do that. Yeah, and it's especially every couple of weeks. On one of the websites, somebody claimed that the reason that the ice maker locks up all the time is that because it's getting too much water shooting in with too much pressure into the ice making element.
Understood.
So what you have to do is you have to seek out and find what is referred to as the butterfly valve that controls the water pressure at the refrigerator site. Now, what they tell you is that the butterfly valve is normally located on the little water tube in back of the refrigerator.
Right.
So I haul out this big, heavy refrigerator that does not move easily, and I see a tube coming out of a hole in the wall, no butterfly to be found.
Hmm.
So after that, weeks went by. I didn't even bother with it. I said, I'm not going to deal with this. I'm not going to worry about it. I'm not going to care about it. Last night, for some reason, Carla cleaned the garage out, and I had access to where the water comes in. I said, well, maybe there's a butterfly valve for that little tube where the water comes into the house.
Mm-hmm.
No, no. In fact, there was no, I didn't even find where the water main was. So I didn't know what
did
I was doing.
Did you find the main valve? Like the it's used
did not find the water main, but I wouldn't turn that down because that controls all the water.
I was
going to
say, do
house.
You have good water pressure like in your shower?
Relatively good.
All right.
So then I said, aha, I have a moment. I have a moment that is just like ding, 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 ding. God damn it, ding. Why isn't that working? You know what? Sometimes I really hate my equipment.
Sometimes?
I really do. What's the deal here? Come on now. Where's my...
Is it the volume?
Nothing's working. I don't know what's going on.
Mike, here you go. Say you had an idea.
I had an idea.
Oh, there we go.
And I said, Mike, How about under the sink in the kitchen?
Like Norm McDonald.
I says, hey, how about that? I'll go in. So I go in, and there are 10 different tubes and hoses and stuff. There's a disposal.
Right.
There, the two. But I look and I see the matching coil that comes
pipe.
Off the butterfly valve.
Nice.
And I turn, and what I do is I test all the different butterflies. They're like 3, 4, 8 butterfly mm-hmm. valves underneath there. And I turn them off, then I test the water. Then I turn it off, then I test the water. Finally, I turn it off, no water coming out. I found it. So now the experiment
is... Oh, so you're testing
it
with the water dispenser because it's obviously the same feed.
It's the same feed.
That's brilliant.
Thank you. I thought so, too.
Yes.
I thought it was fabulous. I thought it was absolutely brilliant. And now I said, one of the ways that I can tell that it's getting too much water is when you put the ice thing underneath the machine, it spews out a little water before the ice comes out. And so I said... I'll let the ice make overnight, yeah. and then I'll come mm-hmm. back and well, it peed again. It spewed water out.
Oh.
Again. So I don't know. I don't know if that's the key to it. So
did it fill? But did you have an appropriate amount of ice in your bin?
Yeah, it was. I mean, it's starting. It's starting to make it.
So
I have to ask Oscar a question. What a lovely backdrop you have today with that green camo
you.
And the
thank
TMOS
you.
Logo. And the did you set that up yourself?
I decorated
where
myself
where are
last
you? You're
night.
From a You're from a different location, correct?
Yeah, I'm in our M2 studio, our second studio. Mike, you actually didn't get a chance to see it because it wasn't built yet. In downtown, well, for the cross street, 1900 M Street, downtown D.C.
Mm-hmm.
Rob's just above Georgetown, and I'm roughly 2.1 miles away, or 1.7.
Mike, don't feel bad. I've not been invited to the studio either.
Is this where you're going to be? Well, I went to the studio facility. I just
yes.
didn't get a chance to see
oh,
the
see.
New studio he was building for TMOS down there. So is this where you're going to be for the foreseeable future?
Yes, yes. And Maddie should this is actually one background that I'll be using, Mike, because I'll be this is like a version 1.0. Because I had like three other versions going.
Is that
like,
virtual this, or is that a real background?
No, this is real.
Yeah, those are the letters from the improv show, aren't they?
They are.
I didn't know we still had them. That's
keep
cool.
Keep everything.
Yes.
Throw nothing right. away.
That's
How
cool.
are you doing? Are you tired today? You look tired.
No.
Tired.
I'm. My. You know, my soul has been drained, Mike.
Why? Now, you know what? I'll let you have your moment and vent. Let's take
no,
a break.
No, I don't want to complain.
No, I do. I enjoy it. Your pain is entertainment to me and a lot of our listeners.
Yes.
Let's do that. His soul is drained. I know it is. And I want to lift you up.
Thank
I want to lift
Thank
you up after that.
Thank you.
We'll
Thank
take
you.
A break. We will come back. And it's psychotherapy for Oscar. And maybe he can talk about going to see the people at the MAGA rally. We'll do that when we come back on the Mike O'Mara Show. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show. Cornerstone First Financial is a wonderful local business that has branched out all over the country. And we're very, very excited to be associated with them. And if you haven't checked recently, a lot of our listeners are getting amazing deals on their mortgages. They really, really are, because mortgage rates are at an all-time low. And that means people are getting back into the housing market. It's very, very, very exciting. And you don't want to read about this in the history books. You want to take advantage right now. And somebody that can help you with that, Mark Livingstone and all his great people at Cornerstone First. They're fantastic. And you can call the only company I recommend, because I've used them, Cornerstone First Financial. Other companies advertise ultra-low rates, but don't tell you that they're charging you a ton of origination fees and points. Listen. With the rates where they are at this level, you'll never need to refinance again. Call the loan professionals at Cornerstone and don't miss out on being a part of history, whether you purchase, refinance, cash out, or get a lower rate and shorter term. 202-625-1221 or cornerstonefirst.com. Cornerstone First Financial, personal attention from application to closing. Now, full disclosure
yes.
on the Mike O'Mara Show. We do a lot of work technically, especially when we're moving from place to place to place. And whereas in the days of radio, I loved doing the show, but the soul-crushing element was dealing with the suits, the GMs, the doing that. That no longer exists for me in that negative way. We control our own destiny with our business. Oscar and I have, and Rob have business meetings. Where we try to get things worked out. We do a lot of creative things.
Mm-hmm.
The thing, but there's always something that's soul-crushing. In my case, and I believe in Oscar's case also, what he's referring to today, is technical issues.
Yes.
Where it becomes evident that we are not engineers, And that it's very, very frustrating. Well, the thing is, and I'm going to give you a compliment, Mr. Santana, but with the technical side of everything, whether it's computeries, whether it's audio cable, whether mm-hmm. it's line, you have, because you put together so many of the operations,
yes.
you've become a rather significant savant at this.
Yeah.
No one else is. No one else in this operation is. Mm-hmm. Rob is not. Pony is not. Mike is not. Pony does better than I do. Rob maybe does a little better than I do.
I'd say we're about tied, you and I.
But you do it more because you kind of, on the recording end of things, you can...
Yeah, we want to make
you
sure
you edit better.
Perfect.
You can throw something together at a moment's notice. I don't have that capability. I barely can get a recording done in here.
Yeah, but
so,
Mike, you can
that's
hold
it.
The Butterball lady on for 40 minutes.
That's
I can
right.
keep the you know what? I can keep the Butterball lady on that. My skill sets are different.
I love it.
We you didn't even have those... to pull out fake tears for 18 minutes. That was strong.
and the fake tears were not keep her on the line. It was the comedy move at the time, I thought, just to get emotional.
There was a part of her that wanted to know more about Timmy O'Brien.
I know she did. Well, he took my eyebrow off.
I know, but didn't hurt your vision.
So today was one of those soul-crushing days where we got the Butterball thing all ready to go. We're ready to dive in. We're going to do it a week before because next week you're not going to be able to get through on that line.
Right.
So, Oscar, you take it from here. I'm going to try to work on my soundboard, which I still don't know how to work.
No problem whatsoever.
Your ding.
I figured it out.
I think I just barely heard it.
That's it.
Thank you. All right, very good. I got it.
For a fact, our show prides itself on being 100% like on the ball, sounding as great as possible, beyond our expectations that we ever had in broadcast radio. And I really mean that.
It's the truth.
So much so that this studio has been up and running for roughly 2 weeks. We have a different set for another pretty big show that comes through here. And I wanted to do something special for our show, since a different background here. And but prior to the background and setup, I got on the horn with my wonderful friends Pony and Rob yesterday for roughly 2 hours, and we went through multiple different iterations of making sure everything sounded perfect.
So that your studio down on M Street would link up with our studio on Wisconsin Avenue in Washington D.C. and me down here in the Sunshine State, home of the greatest governor in the world, Ron DeSantis.
Have you gotten your bumper sticker yet?
Yeah, not yet.
Not yet.
Looking forward to it.
Which for us is old hat. We literally have Mike in Florida or Maine at any time, or Rob in Leesburg, and to connect two studios to each other should be turnkey.
Right.
Turnkey. The only thing I cannot account for is people on the other side of the equation I can't hear what they're hearing, right? So we come in today before the show starts, and there's a hum on one of the connections we have.
It was more like this. This is what I heard.
Yes. And I, unfortunately, internalized that as physical pain because... Why did we sit on the horn yesterday?
I'm not the only one that gets angry here.
2 hours.
Oscar gets angry too.
Well, yesterday when we were doing it, we were connected, we were solid, we were hearing you, all was well. But we assumed on this end it was air conditioning noise.
There was something going on. Yes.
Right. So when we left it, that's what I thought. I thought we were.
So then I can buy into that, which is fine.
Right.
But then when there's something to be done to fix it, it's like. There is no communication. There is no molasses.
Terrible.
It's like slow molasses.
I heard it. I was an observer. I had a meltdown.
Tell me what's going on.
Maddie, send me the bill. I owe you another. You and Pony another 10 each.
No, you know what?
I really did have a meltdown. I really got pissed
off. I think you're excused. And even if you pay, why would Pony get the $10 if he caused it?
No. I don't know, Rob. In fairness,
right?
You technically are his supervisor.
This is true.
There are some times where I think you guys are equal because of the way you act, but you are his senior and you're his supervisor.
Right.
So you really have to take the onus there, as I have to take the onus on you guys. Right?
Understood.
So you're a reflection of me, which burns me up even more. So on my end, poor Mike's down at home. He's expecting to connect right away. and everything's going to go perfectly because the guys have we've done the work yesterday.
I wrote a little Dick Oliver while I was hearing you in the background. I didn't. You know how long I was there? Yes. I was there for about 6 minutes. I heard that clusterfuck going on, and I didn't want to. Connect with
you're
anybody.
Good, you're a good man.
You multipurpose. You multitask. So it was good.
And what you should know, Mike, beyond this is yesterday, I'm giving Rob the pep talk of pep talks. I said, "Hey, man, you got to get on your A game. You got to learn Zoom. You got to learn that board again. You have to." And I'm giving him everything he needs to know because he's at mission control.
Right.
And the questions I was asking him yesterday, didn't really have answers to. I said, "This is not going to fly because if you hesitate or stutter at all, Mike is going to go crazy." So we don't want that.
I mean, as far as the connection and stuff like
that. You like things happening quickly, or if there's an issue, you want it resolved quickly, which I appreciate. I think that's important.
You're saying I have a problem with patience.
No. What he's saying, Mike, is the entire industry is based on urgency and deadlines.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, no, when we have a guy come in on a Zoom call, whether it's a TMOS talking head, whether it's anybody else or a guest that pops in now, because we're doing a lot of video guests, which is great. We need to have it in short order, and we don't have to have it. We have to do some things like they do. We do it without the television capabilities of like a major news organization. Mm-hmm. But like, for example, when I'm talking to you guys, I don't want to have a head down in the lower right-hand corner of our video presentation that no one has identified yet because they decided to pop in.
Right.
And it's controlled by them, and we have to figure out a way where we control that.
It's a lot of behind the scenes, but it was a big pep talk before the big game yesterday for everybody, especially my friend Rob, to say, hey, you got to know this thing inside and out. I know that you have a learning curve. I know you've been at home for a while, but please. And like anybody would. Like, you expect that there's a learning curve. And then the day of days, the first day we're here, and I'm not there, you're there, I'm here. Something happens where exactly what I said was going to happened.
But also, when we finished yesterday with the lengthy test and we had the one item that we needed to remain to be fixed, you said you were going to be here today.
Correct.
Which is why I did not expect the link up. And also, I know that you had a moment where you were linked up and we weren't hearing you because I didn't know you were going to be there today.
Yeah, but Rob, this is the deal. Those are all excuses. They just are.
Well, I'm trying to make an explanation.
But it's the preparation for the big game, right? You have to be prepared, regardless if wherever we are, to do the same job.
The idea is to run it like we are on a broadcast timetable.
Understood.
That's the way, but we don't, and because we don't, it's in the back of our minds that we are taping. And it really ultimately is not. And I think that is probably in everybody's mind.
And at the I'm sorry to cut you off. Could we have figured out that there was a hum? Yes. All day we figure out if there's hums and how to fix them. I just wasn't there on that side of the equation to hear that.
So why were you not where you said you were going to be?
I was here.
But why were you not at Wisconsin when you said you were going to be at Wisconsin?
Because I figured out how to turn down the AC in this room, and I just, it was set up.
So you figured you'd do it from that location?
Yes.
All right.
Because we're all going to move to this location. It's just going to be Rob and Pony in the other one. Maddie's coming out here tomorrow.
Maddie might be there now.
I got to cycle that through.
I understand and I apologize. I'm sorry that I was slow on the uptake, but I didn't. As soon as I found out you were connected from there, that's when I potted you up.
I get that.
Did we ever find out what the was?
I'm banking that it's just a cable that was not, when it was hooked up, it wasn't hooked up correctly on
right.
that.
Right. Okay.
But this sounds
great. Do you feel better?
It's nice and clear.
Do you feel better than? Isn't it great to get that off your chest?
Oh,
you're being
it feels
a little
so
too controlled.
Much,
you know,
so much better. Mike, after a while, you stop being surprised by.
But it still hurts.
Yes.
I understand. It's frustrating. You want a little more, you know, vim and vigor. I get it. I know how that works.
What did I say to them yesterday? I said, guys, listen, I'm not going to be a jerk about this, but you need this more than Mike needs this. So
let's figure this out. Rob and Pony will be at one place and you'll be down here?
I'll be downtown. Yes.
Yes. So we're going to be now three different locations.
Yeah, but the beautiful part about here, Mike, honestly, I would love to get the entire crew here rotated, is because we have a fiber line in this building.
Okay.
That's a direct line to the building, and which would make anything, even connection issues.
And ultimately, the plan is to get everybody down there
to rotate everybody.
Yeah, because we all need more fiber.
Okay. Thank you, Betsy.
Hard and shoes then he does when you come that. Here. Hard shoes and when then you he come does here, that. Rob.
Yeah, hard shoes.
No Birkenstocks.
No.
You know what? If we're back in the same studio, you might not want me with hard shoes. You might like something soft.
I get it. So right now we're keeping Pony and Rob in the basement. I understand.
Yeah, you know who we are, Mike? The simple-minded cousin. I'm Fredo. I'm smart!
It's good when the big wigs come in to have you guys in the basement. Let's take a break.
What school do you go to?
We will come back with I don't know what. I'll talk to Maddie when we come back right here on the Mike O'Mara Show. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show, brought to you by Solo Stove. Okay, it's here. It is here. It is here. It is here. It is here. We have our cold snap.
Oh, good.
In Florida. It was absolutely wonderful. It would be perfect. I'm off to find. The question is, down in the great state of Florida, where do I find firewood? And not exactly stacking it up in front of the grocery stores like they do in D.C. Yes, Rob, you're chomping at the bit.
I will say Friday, Julia comes home dragging her hands on the ground because she's had a hard day of her three-hour job, and she's carrying a grocery bag. I said, what have you got? She says, chocolate marshmallows and graham crackers. I'm making s'mores. And so I set her up with a little fire at the Solo Stove, and she is as happy as she can be in this coronavirus world, sitting outside making s'mores, and it's the perfect time of year to do it.
Let's tell people what it is. Solo Stove is this phenomenal little bonfire fireplace. Yep. It creates the moments. Stainless steel construction designed to regulate airflow and burn more efficiently. So little smoke, you'll wonder how there's so much fire, plus no campfire smell in your clothes and nothing but ultra-fine ash for easy cleanup. Solo Stove. It's a backyard fireplace for you. The products are portable. You can take them anywhere. They're easy to light, totally portable. And Solo Stove gives a lifetime warranty with every purchase. You can't beat that. No one needs a reason to gather around the fire. Solo Stove just took away any reason not to. And now you can get $10 off when you use promo code TMOS at checkout. Just go to solostove.com. And remember, get $10 off when you use promo code TMOS. This is the week we bust that thing out. I am so excited.
What is your
come in here and
evening
tell you
evening low tonight in Florida?
Probably in the, you're going to laugh at me.
No,
it's
not
probably close to 61, 62 degrees.
But that's good fireplace weather. That's perfect.
Good fireplace
that's
weather.
Perfect.
I am looking forward to it. We'll get to Maddie. Is the Maddie story worth, that's a segment, so I don't know.
It's a segment, and it's a wonderful, because none of us have ever been the daughter of a mayor.
Right. It's very, very exciting. Maddie, how you doing over there?
I'm great. I feel a little bit cheated out of the $20. I'm not gonna lie, but that's okay.
Send me a bill. Okay. I'm not gonna cheat.
Give her the full 20.
You get the 10
Give
bucks.
Her the full 20.
Okay.
Maybe.
No, Pony gets it too. Pony, why should I give you the 10?
I think you're just gonna get silenced. He's not hooked up.
Yeah,
right
he's not listening. I see him right now. Okay.
Well, that's it. You get the 20.
Okay.
All right, that's the way that works. Sorry, sometimes it's just the luck of the draw. No, he needs the 10.
That's
too.
A shame. $10 would buy him a set of earbuds.
That's exciting.
He could listen.
Very, very exciting. We've only got a few seconds here where I just wanted to express myself. I think I might have mentioned the Giants, my New York Giants. And I know we have a lot of Redskins fans that listen to this show, but it is hysterical to me that since I'm a huge football fan, that my particular team, the New York Giants, have only won 3 games. They are 3-7, and they are in the hunt.
Yes!
They are in the hunt in the NFC East because the NFC East sucks so bad.
It's the
and
worst.
There are a lot of people talking about it ought to be a meritocracy on all teams in the NFL. No! That's the way you do it. It's divisions. Yeah. Don't change that. If the division happens to suck, the best of the suckies get to go to the playoffs.
Right.
I'm down with that.
And play one playoff game.
That's right. But it's, I said that if they beat the Philadelphia Eagles, which they did,
yes,
it would now turn. I am just stunned that I've been with them since the beginning. I was trying to explain this to my son today, really briefly, okay? I was trying to talk about Trump.
Just brief.
The Giants and the Red Sox and my history of rooting for losing teams and losing things in my life, whether it's an athletic contest or a job where you have to accept it and you have to move on and put a good spin on it. That's sportsmanship. But as far as spectator sports are concerned, this is one of the best ever, all right? I will give you a generation of fans of, let me, a random team, the New England Patriots.
Right.
13, 14, 15, then they get to be 16, 17. These are kids that have no idea what losing is, and they are brats. They are spoiled. They are arrogant. It turns you into a not nice person. If you are the long-suffering fans of, say, the Cleveland Browns, or you're the long-suffering fans of the Washington Capitals, when you have the moment, and as far as, sorry, Cleveland Browns, that hasn't happened in a while, when you have the moment, it makes the moment more special than any sixth or seventh championship. Anybody that tells you in this country that is so obsessed with the big win is lying to you when it's when they tell you, you know, a sixth championship is as good as the first. No, there's nothing that compares to rooting for a team that hasn't won a lot in recent memory. Now, the Giants have. But to be able to come back after a big, long drought, I give you the Redskins. When it happens to the Redskins again, you're going to have decades of people that don't know. It's a special, special time. And so you embrace the losing, and you take the small victories, and it teaches you how to do that. And what you do, no matter win, lose, or draw, you show. And I said to my son today, we're in the car waiting for the school bus. I said, I want to teach you a word. Gracious.
Good word.
You are gracious. And we're I hope that whatever team you're on, I hope that we can get back, maybe, while this particular man is no longer sitting there at the top of the free world, that we can get back to it. Republican or Democrat. There's stuff going on that I don't think people behave the way they used to behave before all of this happened.
You should be able to disagree and frankly,
disagree.
At the end of the day, you can still get together and have a beer.
But you lose and you move on.
Yeah.
And there are plenty of your guys won. And our guy won the big one. But there are plenty of your guys that won too. So come on. Let's pull together. So I hope it gets that way. And, but, you know, that's with the Giants sitting there at the beginning of the season where I'm going, suck.
Well, it's a garbage division, Mike.
It's a horrible division.
It's a horrible division. But it happens to be, but it happens to make Sundays now, Sunday. An exciting endeavor for me.
And so congratulations to the people of Cleveland who had an NFL championship in 1964.
Oh, 1964.
That was it predates the Super Bowl.
Mike, you've had Super Bowls in New York.
I've had Giants Super Bowls. I've had Red Sox victories.
But
I've had the Washington Capitals win a Stanley Cup.
To see that
every
happen.
One of my teams has done it. I'm sorry to keep getting so manic. To Jimmy Cerrito, my dear friend.
Yes.
Jimmy and Matty Masiello, who roots for the same team. My extreme sympathies for what is one of the probably the most heart-wrenching loss of the year. And well, Maddie, sitting there when I think we asked you about were you sitting there when that happened?
I was honestly, all I could do was laugh because it's hilarious that we blew such a big lead that we got it back and then lost in the end. It's honestly hysterical. I'm still pissed off, actually, now that
let me
talk about
give
it.
You Maddie's type of laugh, okay? This would be the laugh she's talking about.
It's like you were there, Mike.
Mike, that makes him the fire marshal Bills.
Yes. Oh, man. Yeah. Sports. Stupid, but we love it. We'll take a break and come back with more on the Mike O'Mara Show, everybody. News you may not need coming up next. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show, brought to you by MyBookie. Hey, we love MyBookie. Get in on the fun with MyBookie, where the action never stops. Whether you're a first-timer, you've been playing for years, you're going to love MyBookie. If you want to root for sports, makes it fun when you get a little on the line.
Sure.
Don't miss their huge casino program. I haven't. You get access to all the classic tables, slots, and card games. And the best part is, at MyBookie, the doors never close. I'm Mike O'Mara. I guarantee it. Please let me back in, MyBookie. Please.
The door, she is locked.
Well, a little thing called exceeding what you... Anyway, use promo code TMOS.
That's a
little to sign up to grab yourself a free $20. I love it. I'm there all the time when I can be. A free $20 bet with your deposit. The terms are simple. You make your deposit, use the code, and you get hooked up with a free bet to use on anything in the sports book. If you've been on the fence about trying your hand at betting, this is a great way to get in on it. And since it's on the house, you can't beat it. It's officially winning season at MyBookie. Join in on the fun and win some cash while you're at it. I love MyBookie, and you will too.
News.
Nuss. Gremlins in the house. Gremlins in the house. Ryan Reynolds is feeling all philosophical after the death of his fellow Canadian, Alex Trebek. Here's his quote. It says, "It forces you to look around a little bit and see the people and the faces that are in our lives every day and really to remember to not take them for granted." I agree with that. Yep. "I was talking to Alex on the phone 2 months ago, and that was amazing. Then, just like that, he was gone. You just never know. Tomorrow is not a given. Hug him tight, the people in your life. It was really shocking and sad. Obviously, he was sick, and it wasn't totally wildly unexpected. It's still heartbreaking nonetheless." Mm-hmm. It's absolutely gut-wrenching. And a lot of people felt that way about Alex Trebek. And maybe we didn't talk about it a lot that day, but did anyone handle his curveball in life with more grace and dignity?
Not at all.
There's that word again, grace, graciousness. It's so important. It's so important. I don't know if I come anywhere close of where I'd want to be compared to other people that show class and grace, but it's a real good thing to aspire to. And it's a good thing to raise your children to aspire to. I don't care if you win. I care if you show grace and graciousness in under pressure situations and to other people.
Are you
wish
finding
I was
it,
better that way.
Are you finding it hard to watch Jeopardy now that he's gone?
I don't watch it at all. I haven't watched it since
I haven't turned it on. It's just it's
still
a weird
running
experience.
His episodes.
Yeah, they'll be airing new episodes with him until Christmas. Because remember,
really?
He shot, I think, up to 10 days or something like that before he passed.
I might look in on it just to see it.
It was
a
weird experience for me. Very weird. Very weird.
Really?
Yeah, just because it's just, you know he's gone.
Yeah, it's sad. Yeah. But safe travels, Alex Trebek. If we didn't say it the day after you passed, we'll say it now. Here's a nice little switch in gears. How many sexual partners are too many? How many are not enough? We have some celebrities. How many do I have here? I have a total of 14. I'm going to go through all 14.
Are these 14 celebrities or 14 sexual partners?
These are 14 celebrities and their partners.
Okay.
And it starts with Amy Schumer. In her 2016 memoir, she said, quote, "To date, I've slept with 28 people. I can't remember all of their names, but I remember the nicknames I gave them. Third Ball, Pitbull Guy, Cousin Steve."
Oh, no.
Oh, God, Amy Schumer can be funny in that. Number two, Lamar Odom, over 2,000. Three, Vinny Guadagino from Jersey Shore.
Oh, yeah. Vinny.
More than at least 500, maybe more than 1,000. Gene Simmons, 4,800. Glad that he got the nice round number.
That's
there.
So weird when it's like, that's a round number, but it's not. Why wouldn't you just say 5,000? Yeah.
4,800.
What happened to your pants again?
My pants mysteriously fell to the floor.
Russell Brand, around 1,000. Charlie Sheen, 5,000. Dennis Rodman, 2,000. Hugh Hefner, over 1,000. Mariah Carey, 5 as of July 19th.
5.
You believe it? Let me see. Dustin Screech Diamond. Is that a Save the Bell guy?
Saved by the Bell, yeah.
Over 2,000.
Did you
Jack
say
Nicholson.
Did you say Dustin Johnson? Or does it
Dustin,
yo,
I'm sorry. No, that's the golfer. Dustin Screech Diamond.
Yes.
Over 2,000. Jack Nicholson, 2,000. Ric Flair, 10,000. John Oates, thousands. Wilt Chamberlain, 20,000. There we are. That's
well, if John Oates has had that many, then Daryl Hall's got to be twice that because he doesn't look like a Cocker Spaniel.
Yeah, but the fact is, John Oates was probably the one that was, trying
it
a little harder. Repeat after me. You're not wasting 4 hours a day playing video games. You're devoting 4 hours a day to wellness.
Devotion.
I'm glad my son is 7. I will not share this story with him. According to a new study out of Oxford University, playing video games can be good for your mental health. I haven't played them in a long, long time, and I'd like to get back into it. The last one I did was Far Cry, and then the most recent version of Far Cry didn't float my boat at all. The researchers found people who played video games had a better sense of well-being than people who didn't. I don't know if it's kids or adults. It doesn't say in this particular story, but I'm not sure.
Robert seems awfully balanced.
Everyone that I know that plays games... two different extremes, like video games. Either they're really successful and they have a really great schedule, or they're really they're underachievers and they still live at home.
They're complete F-ups living with their parents.
And under the still live at home, there's a sub-level, is that hide in your car and tell people you're at college.
Hi, Mac.
Right.
Hi, Mac.
The researchers specifically tested Animal Crossing for Nintendo and found, quote, if you play 4 hours a day of Animal Crossing, you're a much happier human.
Julia loves Animal Crossing.
But she's in college, right?
Yeah, I suppose, yeah.
Is she happy?
Yeah, I think she is. She likes that Animal Crossing, and I go up and she's like, Dad, look what I did, and I've decorated this. There's a lot of artistic aspect to it that I think she finds fulfilling.
And is she enjoying being home, or does she think she wants to get back to college?
I think she's ready to go to college, but she's wise enough to know it's not time yet.
All right. Okay. Yeah. That's good. Nice. That's good. That's good. And she's happy. It says it works. Mm-hmm. Lots of people are trimming their social media friends right now. Some because they can't take people spreading conspiracy theories. Some because they can't take people debunking conspiracy theories. So maybe we don't need this day. But today, if you're keeping track, is the 10th annual National Unfriend Day. Yay. Make sure to take a moment today to cut someone off your list. Friends, and tighten up that echo chamber nice and good. I got lots of slots. I'm going to go the opposite route, and I do this periodically because I'm lazy and I don't want to go through all the requests, which are thousands of them. I really would like you to remind me, and if you've been sitting there a long time and you're thinking about it, send me a PM today and ask to be friended, and I'll put you back on the list.
Can I resend mine, Mike? Is that okay?
No, Rob. Rob, you can keep yours as status quo.
Do you remember you unfriended me when we were racing to 5,000?
I understand. Still blocked. Still blocked.
Still
there we
blocked.
Go. That's it. And now a little something-something, people. An elementary school in France put up a pair of posters outside of their fence at the school with an unusual request for parents that said, don't throw late students over the closed gate. The Trillade School in Avignon put up signs outside its gate showing a cartoon of a parent sending a small child airborne to get over the fence. Principal Sana Mazian said, parents literally flew their children over the gate when they arrived to find it closed. There were only a few scattered incidents and no reported injuries, but there were enough tossed children to inspire school officials to take action and post warnings as a reminder. One of the parents explained that it was easier to throw them over than to squeeze them under the gate because that would squish their little tiny head. Ah, there we are. All right. Don't be late, Jean-Paul. There you go. Don't break your leg. All right, the French.
I'm going to throw you now. Make sure you do not lose your beret.
Right. And for you World War II historians, I don't understand why they even bothered to lock the gate at all. Why
not
even wide open?
Come on in.
Come on in. It's yours for the taking. Terrible, but I know Rob enjoyed that. We'll take a break, and we will come back with the audio ball right here on the Mike O'Mara Show. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show. Beware! The holidays are coming, and there's nothing you can do about it. Nothing, nothing, nothing. Get ready for an unexpected visit from your old buddies, Spike and Surge, the Corona Twins. Yes, sirree. Spike and Surge can't wait to make their holiday visit. So, if you don't want to lose your sense of taste and smell and the ability to breathe, you had better turn off the lights and hide so Spike and Surge don't stop by. Don't worry about the boredom. Just grab your phone and quietly listen to the TMOS Boner Show. If you ain't got it, use needs to gets it. Dirty words, no commercials, lots of... By the way, are we doing the cocktailing this Friday?
No, it's at the end.
It would be the end of the month.
It's not the end of the month.
But next week is Thanksgiving.
Yeah, but there's another one after that, isn't there? Isn't there another weekend after that?
Is there a week after? Get to the calendar. Let me know. All right, Dirty Words, no commercials, lots of Mike, Rob, Oscar to make you laugh. The TMOS bonus show, it makes a great gift for your parking attendant, your sommelier, that cross-eyed rancher, or even yourself. Just go to MikeO'MaraShow.com, click the bonus banner, and you are there. It's the best and funniest way to support TMOS, the bonus show. If you promise to hire us, you'll be safe from coronavirus. Buy it at MikeO'MaraShow.com. Open the door.
It should be this Friday.
What's that?
It should be this Friday. You're right.
We'll do it this Friday. Is that amenable to have you checked?
The next Friday is the day after Thanksgiving.
Precisely.
Yeah.
So done and done. Very exciting.
All right, Mike. We covered the launch of the Resilience, that space capsule from Cape Canaveral, They did a live stream on NASA, and there was a passenger they didn't tell us about. They brought from the Mandalorian Baby Yoda. And so when they did the live stream of the capsule, there's the four astronauts, and a stuffed animal is just floating around.
So funny.
And look at that. Inside the cabin, we have our four astronauts.
Five, actually. We've got Baby Yoda on board trying to take a seat right now, I guess.
I know. I think that's Victor Glover's seat, so hope he doesn't mind.
It is, you know, it's still crazy when they do a stream like that and you just see people and things floating.
Yeah. Here's the thing, though.
And no
this is the best and the brightest still that are out there, and there are those ladies that are at mission control and communicating with the astronauts and the astronauts that are up there. It's just, you know, these people are still chugging along in American society, and these are the moments I get very, very hopeful that it's just a space launch with the mission control and the astronauts and the scientists and the rocket scientists that are making this done. That gives me hope. It also, when I hear these doctors about the vaccine that are being interviewed, there's so many more people, you know, just to, don't worry about the loudest guy in the room. Doesn't matter. What matters are the foundation, which we are still going strong. I'm optimistic. I really am.
And speaking of Star Wars, we all know this sound. But this is a bear that treed itself in Yosemite. And he was complaining because I don't think he wanted or knew how to get out of the tree. So this is Chewbacca. Here's the bear up in the tree in Yosemite Park.
That's an unhappy bear right there.
Yeah, no word as if he got out because he was supposed to be on that space flight. So I don't know if he got out in time. All right, you know how I feel about Canada. They're very polite.
Mm. Well, you're just wrong about it, but yeah.
Well, I'm just saying they're very polite, but maybe you go too far sometimes. This is a tape of a Canadian guy on TikTok who hid a key under his front doormat. Very 1950s way to prevent people from getting locked out of their house. Of course, if you look under the key, under the mat, find a key, you're a robber. You can get right in, right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
But that's not the case with this polite guy who maybe takes it too far.
This is a key. It goes under my welcome mat in a very obvious place. Alex, why would you do that? Isn't somebody going to break into your house? Well, actually, there are a lot of break-ins in this area, and every 6 months to a year, I'll notice that the key's missing, which means people are trying. But here's the thing. It's not the key to my house. It doesn't unlock anything around here. The reason I put it down there is that if a robber finds that key, there's going to be this moment in between the joy he feels thinking he's about to get in to the disappointment, realizing it doesn't work. And I hope that there'll be a moment of reflection there where he'll think, what am I doing with my life?
Okay, right at that point, I'm still okay with it. And I see your face, Mike, you're okay with it too. He's sort of made a robber second guess themselves.
Logic, yeah.
But here's where he takes it too far.
And maybe he'll change. Now, you're probably also wondering, what is that key? I'll tell you. If any of you robbers are seeing this TikTok, look at the number on that key. It unlocks a safety deposit box at the West End Van City Bank in Vancouver. And in that safety box, we got some money, we got a self-help book, and a chance for you to start a new life. Good luck.
A self-help book.
Is it like a Teach Me Sign Language book?
At your core, you are a cynic. You are a cynic.
I agree. Kind of but also...
You just hate Canadians.
Well, I can't imagine what a Canadian self-help book would be like. Help yourself across the border.
Is it pandering? Is that what you think?
Yeah, because we're so special in this country now.
Oh, we're great.
You know, Canadians right now have no desire to roll over here, Rob. I don't know. It's just like, help yourself across the border because we're America.
Well, you know what they are, Mike? They're greedy. They want our land.
Yeah. Because they don't have any land in Canada.
No. It's very tight up there.
Okay, come you know on. What? Yes. I'm winning on every point here today.
You win today. But today. I'll get you, Pee-wee Herman.
Yeah. The only time you win is if they eventually do attack, like you said, for 20 years.
Mike, 99% of Canadians live within 10 feet of the border. Fact.
That is a fact. That is an absolute fact.
This is so extraordinarily sweet. And you may call me a cynic, but I think this will balance that nicely. Wolfgang Van Halen, son of Eddie Van Halen, just released his first single. It's called Distance.
I read about it. I haven't heard the song. I'm glad you
well,
have.
Well, I don't have the song itself, but I'm going to play you a portion that is tacked on to the song. It's a voicemail from Eddie that he has kept for years. Okay. And he's releasing it as part of the song.
I'm just so happy to have you as my son, man. So proud of you. I love you so much. Call me if you get a chance. Just want to hear your voice. Okay? I love you. Bye.
Powerful yep. words of, oh, I'm so proud sweet. Of you. That is so sweet. That is so sweet. So I'll find that record and I'll play it. But I wanted to just highlight
that.
He kind
of oversold that one, to be honest with you.
You think he's going to attack?
It's waiting for something really moving. I mean, that's me. I do that before 11 a.m. every day with my kids. You know, I'm sorry. That's so
yeah,
cynical.
But you know, Mike, that's going to be a lot more valuable to your son after you die. To be fair.
Which is soon. Which
that
will
is
be soon.
Exactly.
Yeah, absolutely.
And are you pleased that your daughter is no longer in New York City?
Very much so. I am very curious about her journey in Los Angeles
right.
and how she does out there. And, you know, it's I'm proud of her. I think she's been through a hell of a lot in her young life, and I really I'm glad she's starting a new life, which well, she probably had to do.
Let's close with this, because it's good that she got out of New York City for several reasons, not at least the weather. The weather is crazy in New York City.
The National Weather Service issued a rare tornado warning for Manhattan and the Bronx, though in the case of the Bronx, the warning was for the tornado.
That is your magic audio vault. Have a great Tuesday, everybody.
That's New York, baby. Hey! That's the way we do that. Hey, everybody. Well, I guess we can discuss tomorrow, but it looks like we're going to probably be doing a cocktail party on Friday night before the holiday.
Excellent.
And my daughter Elizabeth might be coming into town at the moment that is happening, so that should be interesting. And we can have her, like from a social distance, join us on that because we're going to get her tested when she gets here. That's the way that goes.
More ice, Dad!
There you go. Thank you. That's it. We got to get out of here. Thanks to the Butterball Turkey Hotline.
Yes. Marcy.
And Marcy, who's not the B word. And sincere apologies. It was shtick. I was simply doing shtick. For Rob Spiewak, Stop It, and Oscar Santana, Mike O'Mara saying so long, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Ciao, ciao.
Before you go, please make a mental note. Today's show was made possible by the TMOS bonus packages. You can secure yours right now by going to MikeO'MaraShow.com and clicking on the red bonus banner. Buy it or give it. Either way, you're helping out TMOS, and that's a good thing. Thank you, and go in peace.
Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment.
Do you know who I am? I'm Mo Green.
That was a hot mess inside a dumpster fire, inside a train wreck.
It's Dungeon. They pack your things. They're loading your car.
Well, bye.